Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about the star topology. In last two videos we discussed ring topology and bus topology. So in the bus topology, all my computers are connected in a common share cable called as backbone of cable, and we called it as bus topology. In the ring topology, we saw all your computers are connected in a wired, or they are connected in a circle, and every node is connected to its neighboring node on the either side. Now we'll have a look on the star topology. If you'll see the diagram here, all my nodes are connected to a hub. Hub is a device which sends or receives the signal to the appropriate destination. Now see here, all my five nodes are connected to hub. Now suppose my nodes are node number 1, node number 2, node number 3, 4, 5. Suppose if my node number 1 wants to communicate with node number 4, then he cannot communicate directly to the node number 4. First, he has to send the data to the hub, and then hub will route its data to the appropriate destination. So this is the working of star topology. All workstations are connected to a central hub. Since all my computers are connected to a central hub, here my control is centralized. So hub receives the signal from workstation and routes it to a proper destination. In this, adding new station is easier. Why adding new station is easier? Because your nodes are not connected to each other. Your nodes are connected directly to a hub. So adding new station becomes easier in the star topology. Whereas in the bus topology or is in the ring topology, all your nodes are connected to each other. So if you are adding any new node in between, then it becomes difficult to add a new node. But in the case of star topology, since your nodes are connected to hub, you can directly detach or attach node to the hub. Then control is centralized. As we discussed, there is a hub, and hub receives and sends the signal to the appropriate destination. So the control is a centralized. Hub failure affects all users, but the disadvantage in the star topology is that if the hub gets failed, then it will affect all the user, and the hubs are slightly expensive. So this was about the star topology. In the star topology, all your computers are connected to a hub. Hub is the one who sends and receives the data to the proper destination, or you can say hub is the one who routes the data to the proper destination. If the computer A wants to send data to a computer B, then computer A cannot directly communicate with computer B. Computer A has to send the message to the hub, and then hub will transfer its data to computer B. So this was about the star topology. So in this session we studied all three topologies: ring topology, bus topology and star topology. In the next video we will have a look on the connectivity devices. Thanks for watching this video. For the latest video, please subscribe the channel Ekeeda.